Let me introduce myself. So I am from the Deggendorf Institute of Technology. I am professor in this field of energy systems engineering. And this study program, actually, it is at one of the campuses of the university, which is the European campus Rottal Inn. And just a minute, is not, slides are not moving on. Yeah, okay. So, and when we are talking about, so this actually session of today, this webinar is about electrical engineering in general, where you might ask yourself what energy systems engineering is doing into that. Well, actually, most of the energy forms, most of the issues and challenges that we have to address are in the field of electrical energy. Therefore, it is very well fitting into this topic. When we are talking about energy, I have to mention perhaps some facts, which is putting into the context why we need to have energy systems engineers, why we need, what are the challenges in that field. And in that respect, let me give you here some numbers about our global consumption of energy. When I mean global world consumption of energy, and you can see here the distribution of different energy forms. So I'm most particularly fossil energies that we are using as primary resources like coal, gas, oil. You can see that the distribution of them is more or less one-third of each of them. And only a minor portion of it is coming from renewable energies or hydro energies and or eventually nuclear energies. When we are looking to numbers, well, the numbers are enormously high. So here you have a unit that I'm introducing, EAJ, which is exajoule, which, as you can see here, is 10 to power 18. That's a really, really huge number. And if you are looking to our global consumption, we can find out that this is the consumption that we have, world consumption, so about 500 exajoule, or there is another unit or are other common units that are used in that point of view, for example, the gigatons of oil equivalent. Sometimes it is used as an alternative form to that. According to that, we have that amount. Yeah, so 13, nearly 14 gigatons of oil equivalent. What that means, actually. Yeah, so this is just a number, perhaps it's not telling us much. But if we are looking to that amount of gigatons of oil, then and thinking on such kind of rail tanks, well, we can fill in, as you can see here, nearly 180 million of such rail tanks with oil, with the amount of energy that we are using each year. So that's a huge amount of energy. Still, perhaps it's not saying much. Well, if we would make a train out of that, the length of the train will have the 78 times the perimeter of the Earth. So you can have an idea about energies that the amount of energies that we are using right now. And if you are looking to how was in the past and how is that in the future, well, we are still continuing to use more and more. And we are using a lot since several decades, and it is still continuing to increase. If you are looking to a kind of forecast on that, let's say in 10 years, you can see that there are some changes, not much, but there are nevertheless, actually the amount of other forms of energy will increase to higher the renewable part, perhaps a little bit higher hydro, and eventually nuclear as well. Let's see that perhaps in the next slide, where there is a longer forecast on that, actually, which is starting, is going back to 100 year. And we can see that we started to use these huge amounts of energy somewhere mid of the last century. And we are continuing to increase, to consume more and more. But what is important, we are now approaching a kind of transient period when we are at the point of depleting our resources. And this transient period is particularly critical because, as you can see, we start to have significant changes in the ways how we are looking and we are handling energies. More particularly, we will decrease in the next few decades, we will decrease the amount of fossil fuels, and we will try to rely on more and more on renewable and also nuclear. These changes, are rising a lot of challenges for the today's society, and actually that's the main reason why we are addressing within our study program to train people for this transient period. And so that's a pretty old diagram, but it is very well confirmed by recent statistical analysis made by this company who is taking every year actually doing this statistic is the British Petroleum, which is telling exactly the same. So even if that was an old forecast, it is a very good one, by the way. And it is previewing that we will practically use all our oil resources in about 50 years. So we should now think on preparing the people for that, preparing the society. We have to change many things in order to be able to address that, actually to address, first of all, in the immediate this transition period, which needs to change everything, needs to change the consumption habits. First of all, eliminating waste. Now, if we are looking in the engineering point of view, of course, we have to develop new technologies and actually new, more efficient technologies in that respect. Of course, we have to go into the direction of renewable resources or eventually look to new forms of renewables that compare to what we are using right now today. And of course, many other aspects like economical aspects, business models, even changing policies and others that are related to that. That's practically the background on which we started to develop our study program because we want to address these challenges that the society is facing today. And the society needs actually highly skilled professionals that are able to address these challenges. Now, our study program, if we are looking to that we have at the Deggendorf Institute of Technology, the European campus, actually is addressing exactly that. It is looking to this transformation of energy systems that we have in the immediate and in the near future. And our study program is trying to address that in an application-oriented manner. So here you have the structure of our program and also the different semesters within which you have the possibility to study the related content. Our study program is a bachelor study program over 7 semesters. And it's of course oriented about energy systems. We have at the beginning, we have some foundation courses related to general no necessary knowledge for engineers, more particularly in the field of mathematics, informatics, physics, materials, chemistry, and of course electrical engineering, power engineering, also about materials. And then it is going into more specialized topics that are now very much related to the energy systems. And in particularly, as I mentioned, electrical energy is taking a very important role in this point of view because most of these energy forms that I show you in the previous slides, actually, we are not using them as they are. We are transforming them, or most of them, to electrical energy. And we are dealing with electrical energy. And more particularly, here we have topics about power grid technologies, control of that, smart systems and smart technologies related to that one. And as a central point, of course, renewable. And also including development of conventional forms, energy forms, and more particularly looking to sustainability. Now, our study program, as I mentioned, is application-oriented teaching. That means there are a lot of projects, and we also have a practical semester where we are expecting that you will go to a company for an internship to gain more practical experience beside what we are trying to transmit you through the study program. Now, in the point of view of career perspective, you can see here, so this is actually a brochure of the energy systems engineering that you can find on the webpage. So here you have the link to that. This is the main webpage of the university, and within that, the energy systems engineering bachelor program. I did not mention, but this is a bachelor program in English. Actually, our campus, the European campus Rotal Inn, we have teaching nearly exclusively in English. And if looking to an overview of the different topics that we have, perhaps here we can identify on the first two semesters these general courses that I mentioned related to general math, informatics, well, electrical engineering at different levels, the beginning introduction, then later on going into the direction of power engineering, and later going into the direction of measurement and control engineering, and then, yeah, specializing for different aspects related to energies, including also energy economy aspects, and so on. You can see here that we have many slots that are dealing with semester projects. So this is a little bit particular. This study program has many semester projects compared to other study, any other energy engineering or other engineering study programs in general. We have a lot of project activities, and including the internship that I mentioned, which is over one semester during the fifth semester. And we also have several slots for electives. And here you can see that we are providing a big number of electives that are trying to further train you in specialized directions that we are considering, well, necessary, but in complement to the fundamental things and the specialized things that we are addressing this within this study program. Of course, the study program is ending in a bachelor thesis. This is also a practical work. Of course, there might be theoretical aspects into that, like modeling, but of course, we are very much expecting practical activities within the bachelor thesis as well. In general, our bachelor thesis we are recommending our students to have such bachelor thesis in collaboration with companies. But of course, we are also offering different topics that are related to our activities, research activities, ongoing activities, so this is the study program that we have is running, and you have the possibility to apply. Now, in the point of view of application, we are just in the application period now for the next semester, which you can see here, it is ending at 15th of July. So you still have the possibility, if you are opting for this study program, to apply. You can apply through our online portal. We have also an assessment system for entrance level. So you have to take a test at the very beginning before applying, and you have to then attach to all your documents actually kind of result, a certificate that you are getting from this test. For further details, I'm sure that my colleagues will help you to clarifying if you have anything in that. We are expecting, as you can see here, that you have a good knowledge of English because teaching is happening in English. And we are also expecting, and it is, I would say, it's a kind of requirement to some extent when you are going into an internship into a company. Of course, there are many companies where you can use, of course, English as well, but in most of the cases, it would be better if you are improving your knowledge in German. So we are expecting that you are learning a little bit of German if you don't know already. And in that respect, there are a lot of language courses that you can take in parallel with the other courses that you have within the study program to improve your knowledge in this respect. And what else that I wanted to mention? Yes, as I said, my colleagues will be pleased to answer to your questions if you have anything in that direction. Well, here, of course, this is just few pictures about our campus. I am welcoming you in at this campus to this study program, actually in Pfarrkirchen. This European campus, Rotalin, is located some 60 kilometers away, 50 kilometers away from the main campus, which is in Deggendorf. But that's a beautiful small little town and very cozy. And yeah, well, so I am welcoming you there. Looking forward to see you soon, perhaps over the next semester. And thank you for your participation.